Thank you for tuning into our seller interview series. Up today, we've got a dropshipping business for sale in the general niche. Created in October 2017, this business makes $7,774 per month in net profit, and the listing number for the business is 45170. We do this interview to give potential buyers more information about both the seller and the businesses they're looking to purchase. We hope these insights are helpful for you in making a buying decision. We've got the seller with us today to go through the business and cover everything from niche selection to traffic and monetization. Damian, thank you for coming on here today. How are you doing?
I'm pretty fine today. Thank you, Jake. Thank you for this interview.
Yeah, of course. Thank you for taking the time. It's a pleasure having you on here, and I'm excited to discuss your dropshipping site with you. But before we dive into the questions that I have for you, yes. I'm going to go ahead and run through a little quick summary of the business. Again, the business was built in October of 2017, has a monthly revenue of $51,221. Yes. Expenses of $43,447 to make for net profit of $7,774, which is generated on a 12-month average. Included in the sale of this business are the primary domain and all site content and files, two Facebook accounts, and the email list. Damian, can you tell us a little bit about your background in building and running online businesses?
Yes, first of all, I'm Damien Sozo. I'm from France. I'm a young entrepreneur on e-commerce since 3 years now. I've built one Amazon FBA business before this dropshipping store. And I decided to create this business last year. It was to train my wife, honestly, because it was just a funny game, a little game. And then 3 months later, we start to go serious on this business and create a real brand business with good image. So yes, it's a young business, but really profitable business. And let's discuss about it.
Yeah, I'm very excited to. So you mentioned that it's profitable, and it certainly is. You know, like I mentioned before, you're making over $7,700 every single month in profit. So why have you decided to sell the business today?
Because honestly, like I mentioned, I got multiple activities now, and I don't have much time, and day is 24 hours, unfortunately. So I have to choose. My option is to sell this business because I want to spend my time on my first love. Yeah, my first love, was cryptocurrency. But now I got to dive into my Amazon business, one other business I got. So yes, I need cash flow, honestly, to put in this business. So that's why I'm selling this dropshipping store.
And that totally makes sense. So how did you come up with the idea to start this business? Why a dropshipping site rather than something like Amazon FBA?
It's a good question. Amazon FBA is pretty good too. It's two different business models. But honestly, I wanted to create a store with a quick win, quick profitability. And I wanted to apply this business model because you don't have to need stocks. It makes sense because I was a purchaser manager in my past life when I was a salary. And I just wanted to give my routine an opportunity to deal with Chinese suppliers and make contracts with them and propose new products with good condition in Europe place for European customers. Mm-hmm. And honestly, dropshipping is very profitable now. And we got a lot of opportunity with this business model. I have great communication with our Facebook contacts. And one point, very important point that I would like to share with potential buyer is dropshipping store everywhere in the world. But honestly, the competitors are less present in Europe now. And it's quite easy to start a dropshipping store here in France and sell all over Europe. And yeah, I just wanted to create something big in a quick time. And honestly, dropshipping is really interesting because you can you can move fast. You can test product fast. There is less competition on the markets. And Amazon FBA is not the same profit margin. You know, there is much more competitors. And it's quite difficult for the moment now with Amazon FBA. And yeah, dropshipping is a really great opportunity for each entrepreneur to make quick profits and go with a great cash flow in minimum time.
As you said, you wanted to make a business that took off quickly, and taking off quickly is exactly what you did. This business has been around for just over a year now, and you're already making, you know, $8,000 every month, pretty much. So, I mean, you've certainly been successful with it.
Yes.
So when speaking to what you do with the business nowadays, you say that you don't have a ton of time to focus on this business. You're doing a lot of other things. So what work is required from you, the owner of the business, to maintain it as is?
The first point is to be familiar with Facebook advertising, because I got three tasks. My routine tasks are monitoring the advertising spending every day. I got to test products every day too. So I try to test one product, every day. And the third point is the team management, because we got 5 employees now. And let's say I have to work 30 minutes to 1 hour a day for the Facebook advertising, 30 minutes on product testing, and 30 minutes with the management of the team to make sure that everybody is going well. And it works great. Thank you, Jake.
Yeah, and so you say you have 5 employees here, and from my understanding, they basically just handle the customer support, chat support, and, you know, sales and stuff like that.
Yes.
So are they willing to continue working with the new owner, you know, through the transition?
Yeah, of course. Of course, it's very important for potential buyer, of course, to be sure that the current organization is stable. And it is. Everybody is really enjoying their task every day. And I got a right hand, a team manager. She is responsible for planning, training, customer relationship, and ordering too. One of my VA is on the email support, and 3 of them are dealing with the chat support and the pre-sale team. So they give coupon to prospects, and we got daily report, and it worked pretty well. So yes, I wanted to have a great organization, because when you do dropshipping, the main problem you can counter is the delivery time. And honestly, I got multiple agreements with all our suppliers to deal with 10 to 50 days. I talk about delivery time, of course. And if you don't have a strong background on your customer service, it doesn't make sense. So yeah, I wanted to create the right organization to the right ambition.
Where does your traffic for the business primarily come from?
Facebook. Facebook ads, because, you know, Facebook is pretty easy to use, and it's the easiest way to advertise products on social media platform. And this is an opportunity for the potential buyer, is we don't have any ads turning into Instagram. Yeah, we got a presence on Instagram, but not on Snapchat, even on Google AdWords or Google Shopping. So that's a great opportunity too, to go on Snapchat and Google Shopping too, and go to the next level with other platform. Because honestly, Facebook is a great platform, and every dropshipper use Facebook, of course, because you can do great figures on this platform. But the next step is to move, not to move totally, but to use other platforms like Snapchat or Google Shopping. And I got a lot of friends who are doing this now, and it works super for them. So I guess the potential buyer got a lot of opportunity to grow up the business and increase the turnover, the profit margin to the next level.
That is certainly an opportunity, expanding to take advantage of other traffic sources and, you know, stuff like that. You also have this email list that has about 20,000 subscribers, and you know, it's generated from past customers, and you have an open rate of 30%, which is, you know, which is really good. So tell me about this email list and how you use it to generate recurring traffic.
Yes. So how company use GetResponse to manage autoresponder and newsletters? The choice of GetResponse is simple, because it's today on the market the most powerful autoresponder, because it minimizes the email sent in the sold in junk box. So when a customer makes a purchase on a website, the customer enters a self-answering machine that sends 21 emails the first month after the first buy. And these emails are of 3 types: information, entertainment, and product promotion. And yes, as you said, the opening rate is awesome. And we make free cash, of course, this email list, because you don't have to spend any penny or any dollar on the ads. So yes, this email list is super powerful now.
Looking to the future, we've kind of already touched on some opportunities for growth, but do you feel like there are any other opportunities for growth for this business?
Yeah, we got multiple opportunity, and honestly, this company is like my baby, so I want the next buyer, the potential buyer, to go to the next level. And yes, there is many opportunity. I can talk about several levers. The first one is develop social networks like branding image on Instagram and Pinterest. We don't do this now, and we should in the future. The next step is to target other marketplaces like the US. This is the biggest marketplace now, and we don't sell over there. So there is a big opportunity to grow. The third step is to test more products. You can hire one more VA and put a job with product testing as a description of this job. One other point is to hire a local agent in China. That's what I'm doing now with my other business, but I got to tell, it's very important to go to the next level. If you want to go to 5 figures a day of turnover, you got to hire a local agent in China, have the experience on it. So I definitely can help the new buyer to go with these points, because you can contract, you can discuss better conditions. I talk about price, delivery time, and you can have faster shipping with this kind of relationship with a local agent. And yeah, two last points. The potential buyer should scale products using manual bidding on Facebook. And as I said before, test new platform to generate traffic like Google Shopping or Snapchat. And currently, Snapchat is growing fast. So yeah, there is multiple levers to go to the next level.
So you mentioned all of those different strategies. And you know, certainly, you know, there's a lot of room for growth for this business. If you were to keep it, what is the first thing that you would do to try to grow?
Honestly, brand image and develop this on Instagram and Pinterest. Because if you get a pretty good brand image on a lot of platform, you can build a relationship with the subscribers. And more subscribers you have, less money you have to put on the table. So honestly, the first point is this. And then I would hire a local agent in China.
Do you feel like there are any potential risks associated with this business that a new owner should be aware of?
I can't say no, because risks are everywhere now in business. But honestly, this is a solid company. And yes, the main risk I can see is if the next buyer, the new buyer, take decision to stay on Facebook and only Facebook. You know, Facebook show us a lot of inconsistency these days. So it will be safer for the new buyer to go to new platforms. That's the main risk, because I don't want this business depend on one and only one platform. And honestly, it's the major risk today. But I guess Mark Zuckerberg is not dying tomorrow, and his platform is going pretty well, and it grows every day. So I guess the future of e-commerce will be on Facebook the next 10 years without any problems. But yeah, you can't depend on one platform.
Would you commit to a non-compete?
Honestly, I'm a new father since 1.5 years now. And I wanted to start a company for, you know, to put my experience and my background to, it's like a challenge. This company was a challenge for me. And honestly, now I'm an ethical person. I'm talking with a lot of transparency with you, Jake. There is no way to put this business down. As I told you, this business is like my baby. So I want the new buyer to be successful. And I don't have the intention to become the next competitor of this company. It doesn't make sense for me.
How much support are you willing to offer a new owner during the transition period?
I guess as much time as the new buyer wants, honestly, because it can't make sense that I can definitely not spend my whole life for the new buyers, but I guess 1 month will be enough for the new buyers to share all the knowledge I have to continue to develop the growth of the company. I talk about suppliers, logistics, marketing, the financial side, of course, too. I guess 1 month is pretty much enough for the new buyer to be comfortable with management of this company. But if, honestly, if the new buyer needs more time, it's not a problem for me. If the new buyer takes 10 days, it would be fine too. But honestly, I don't look at this point so much. I want the new buyer to be successful, though. So 1 month seems correct for me.
Awesome. And I'm sure that makes someone, you know, looking at this feel better that you are really willing to help them be successful here. Are you open, Damien, to negotiating on something like an earnout?
Yes. Yes, I can.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for taking the time with me today. Before I let you go, I have one final question for you. So given your experience in online business and specifically with this one, putting everything together that we've spoken about, why do you feel like this is a business worth buying?
Honestly, this I talk about my experience with my experience and the great opportunity for a potential buyer to buy this company. There is a lot of opportunity. There is a lot of levers, like I mentioned before. But we are doing the promotion of great values, sorry, like smiling, like some stuff around the good life. And honestly, people need a smile and need happiness today. And this is the heart of the company. And it's not a difficult deal for us to promote happiness and smiling. So we promote good values today. We got a great organization. We got a plan, a growing plan for the next year. I talk about product testing. I talk about turnover. I talk about net profits. And to conclude, 7,000 net profits per month is great. But it's really the first level that this company is on, because you can easily go to much more if you spend a little more time and if you spend more money and put more money in the table. So I definitely trust that it's a golden company. And yeah, it's a choice for me to sell it today. But as I mentioned before, I will be present. I will be here for the new buyer to give my time, my experience, of course, to for the new buyer to go to the success and the next level. So
absolutely. And I mean, for my part, you know, I look at this business and it really seems like something that you've done this in just a year, right? You know, this business was built in October of 2017. It is November of 2018 at the time of this recording. So I mean, where can this business go when given more time?
Honestly, maybe 50 to 20K a month. That was my first motivation before I took the decision to sell this business. But honestly, you can move fast and go to 4 to 5 figures a day and go to 10 to 20K a month. I talk about net profits, of course.
Damien, thank you very much for the time with me today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Jake. Thank you for this interview. And sorry for my French accent, but every ladies love it. So I keep
no,
my French
you're right.
Accent.
A lot of people love it. Don't apologize for that. You know, it's I should apologize for not having a French accent.
No, don't. Thank you, Jake.
Yep, my pleasure. If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe to our channel. And if you want more information, the link will be below the video that will take you to this marketplace listing. If you're watching this on the listing page and want more information, become a depositor today. When you make the deposit, one of our business advisors will be in contact with you, and you'll be given everything you need to review this business. Have a great day.